While certain Delta Force operations have been made public, the majority of their missions are classified as highly secret and may never be revealed. But fortunately for you, here's every major Delta Force operation since 1979, with real footage. We begin our big reveal with their very first mission, 2 years after the Delta Force was founded. Operation Eagle Claw. On November 4th, 1979, the Delta Air Force was tasked with rescuing hostages from Iranian students who stormed the U.S. Embassy in Tehran. They trained on storming the embassy and even planned a complex multi-stage rescue operation. But it didn't end well. The plan was to move by night and be inserted by Air Force Special Operations C-130s in a remote location called Desert One, where they met with Marine RH-53 Sea Stallion helicopters. They refueled their helicopters there, and then the team, now composed of Delta and Rangers, flew to a hidden staging location outside Tehran and hid until the next evening. On the evening of the rescue, Delta was supposed to drive to the embassy compound, assault the compound, and rescue the hostages to be extracted at a nearby stadium. Unfortunately, the plan came to a halt when everything began to go wrong. The helicopters suffered erosion caused by sandstorms, the pilots were exhausted, and there were failed hydraulics. On-site commanders recommended canceling the mission, which was heeded to. As the rescue force was leaving Desert One, a helicopter crashed into a U.S. Air Force Special Operations C-130. They all retreated, leaving unauthorized mission plans in Iranian hands. Our next mission reveals a similar Delta Force operation, which unfortunately did not end well. 2. Operation Urgent Fury. On the first day of Operation Urgent Fury in Grenada, a Delta Force mission to attack Richmond Hill Prison and free political prisoners was initiated. But there was a huge problem. Constructed on the ruins of a former fort from the 18th century, the prison was challenging to reach on foot because of the thick undergrowth and a steep ravine. So, with their noses pointing towards the prison, the six Black Hawk helicopters from Delta Force's B Squadron descended into the valley. But they were unable to land and had to start rappelling down ropes that were dangling from the helicopter doors. Then came the shots. Their helicopters were suddenly caught in a crossfire between enemy forces in Fort Frederick, firing heavy small weapons and machine guns from above, and the prison's forces opened fire from the front. Civilians from Grenadine provided eyewitness testimonies, stating that certain helicopters that were capable of leaving the valley did. A helicopter pilot even refused to fly into the assault and turned back on his own volition. But he was later accused of being a coward by other Delta members. 3. Operation Heavy Shadow. In 1993, the operation for the capture and killing of Pablo Escobar, one of the richest drug lords, led by William G. Boykin, involved Delta Force commandos and intelligence support activity, ISA, operatives in Colombia. It was a bit of a problem to find him, so Delta Forces used Beechcraft 300 and Beechcraft 350 aircraft equipped with special surveillance equipment to locate Escobar. It also took the help of the Joint Special Operations Command, Rotating Delta and DEVGRU detachments in Colombia, training and assisting the search block. On December 2, 1993, Escobar's phone was tracked and he was killed in the operation by a sniper. The shooter was probably a Delta Force sniper, but no evidence is available to affirm that. The credit for Escobar's death is generally attributed to Colombian security forces, particularly the search block. 4. Operation Desert Storm. Delta was sent to Saudi Arabia during Desert Storm to assist regular army soldiers guarding General Norman Schwarzkopf. Along with other special forces from the Alliance, Delta was also tasked with searching for Scud missiles. It all got heated when Delta sniper teams discovered 26 Scud missiles in western Iraq on the final day of the ground conflict, all of which were pointed towards Israel. Delta squadrons, armed with powerful sniper rifles, fired in 50 calibers which pierced the fuel tanks of the missiles, killing the crew members. Saddam Hussein might have succeeded in drawing Israel into the war if the Scuds had been launched. "You guys kept Israel out of the war," was prominently written in a letter from General Schwarzkopf, the head of the coalition against Saddam Hussein, thanking Delta Force for keeping Israel out of the ensuing war. If you have been waiting for a bloody operation, this is it. Even its name shows how close they were to death. 5. Operation Gothic Serpent. Delta Force members and U.S. Army Rangers engaged in Operation Gothic Serpent in Mogadishu, Somalia on October 3, 1993. The mission was compromised when the Somali militia shot down two MH-60L Black Hawk helicopters, resulting in an 18-hour battle. It was so bloody it claimed the lives of five Delta operators, six Rangers, five Army aviation crew, and two soldiers from the 10th Mountain Division, a low number when compared to estimates of Somali deaths ranging from 133 to 2,000. Master Sergeant Gary Gordon and Sergeant First Class Randy Shugart, two Delta operators, received the Medal of Honor posthumously for their efforts in preserving Durant's life and the lives of the Super 6 4 crew. Since the Vietnam War, they were the first soldiers to be awarded the Medal of Honor. To show you how big of a history they made, Mark Bowden details the events leading up to the Battle of Mogadishu and the role Delta Force played in the pre-battle activities in his 1999 book, Black Hawk Down, A Story of Modern War. Because of how incredible it did with reviews, director Ridley Scott later adapted the book into a movie in 2001. 6. Counter-Terrorist Training. Following the bloodshed and some minor operations, a British SAS unit and a Delta advance team were dispatched to Lima, Peru in 1997 to guard American diplomats and the Olympic team. This continued throughout their travels and Olympic participation. Also, in nations where the Secret Service has inadequate resources due to violence and unrest, Delta Force and its naval counterpart DEVGRU also guard the president. Notable instances include President Joe Biden's October 2023 travel to Israel, which was spearheaded by Hamas, and President George W. Bush's 2003 surprise visit to American troops in Iraq. 7. Operation Kayla Mueller. It was in this bloody operation that the head of ISIS, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, was killed. It all happened in a raid into the Syrian province of Idlib by the U.S. Joint Special Operations Command's Delta Force on October 26, 2019. The ISIS chief had been a target for a while, and the raid was carried out in response to information gathered by the CIA Special Activities Center. To get him, the eight arranged helicopters and support planes had to cross Russia, Turkey, and Iraqi airspace, and that was no mean feat, given the risky period. When they got there, the Delta Force cleared the compound of anyone. It didn't quite matter if they were either surrendering or being shot and murdered. After carrying out a two-hour raid, Baghdadi fled into a tunnel, set off a suicide vest, and killed himself along with two of his kids. The explosion caused injuries to two Delta personnel and one military working dog, but no serious life-threatening injuries. To wrap up our list, here is another major Delta Force operation. Number 8. The Killing of ISIS Leader Al-Qureshi. On February 3, 2022, when two dozen members of Delta Force surrounded his home in Atma, Syria, Abu Ibrahim Al-Hashimi Al-Qureshi, whose real name is Amir Muhammad, said Abdel Rahman al-Mualla detonated a bomb, killing himself and 13 other occupants of the residence. For the terrorist group leader, it pretty much felt like the only option instead of dying at the hands of a Delta member and being questioned. But that suicide act sort of wasted the efforts of the Delta Force, which had to use attack jets, MQ-9 Reaper drones, and Apache attack helicopters to assist the more than 20 operators who had invaded Al-Qureshi's compound via helicopter. After Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi committed suicide due to being under siege by Delta Force operatives led by Captain Johnny McDaniel, not far from Al-Qureshi's execution site, Al-Qureshi took over as the leader of ISIS, much like a quick changeover to ensure the smooth running of the group. Well, that's it for every major Delta Force operation since 1979. There are a few more that we have not included in this list. If you would like to see more or learn about others, comment below to what you'd like more content on. Don't forget to click on the like button if you've liked our video. You can also subscribe to our channel for more interesting reveals. Till then, stay safe.